You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Yes, good day to you. It is well with us in Jesus' mighty name. We are sharing truth today on the value of a soul. And this comes from John chapter 4, 25 to 32. You are warmly welcome to the Really, Really Knowing God channel with me, Pastor Lanre Adenekan. It's all packaged together by the grace of God to inspire and to instruct people unto better knowledge of God, deeper knowledge of God, richer knowledge of God, and everything is being powered by the Pastor Lanre Adenekan Center for Exuspiration, the place. This is the Daily Gem Devotional, making you a gem to your generation and a gemstone upon the crown of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you're fed up with sense knowledge and you now really desire revelation and knowledge, you are on the right channel. Let us pray. Our God and Father, let your name be glorified, Father God. Thank you for your help at all times. We trust to God that today, as your people will share time with us, let it be something profitable to them, both of us, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We grant to God that that which is learned today will be permanent in the lives of our people, bearing fruits by the hundreds. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, John 4, I think we stopped at 24, but we may very well just go back a little bit. From 22, you worship what you do not know. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father is seeking such to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman said unto him, I know that the Messiah is coming, who is called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us all things. Jesus said to her, I who speak to you, I am he. Let's pause there. I just want to share on you worship, you do not know what you worship. Again, knowing God. There are many people in the category of this woman today. You worship, you don't even know who you are worshiping. And that is so very, very crucial. It's important for you to know exactly who you are worshiping, who you are dealing with, who you are walking with, who you have a relationship with. It's very, very important. This is key. In relationships, any form of relationship where the very person you are relating, you don't even know him well, you don't even know her well, you're looking for trouble at the end of the day. And that's one of the reasons why this channel exists, so that you may really, really know the Lord. Amen. May God help us in Jesus' name. There are times when you think you really know, and you really do not know. So it's important for you to get necessary guidance and teaching from a channel like this, that you may get to know this God and know him well. God help us in Jesus' mighty name. Went on to talk about true worshippers, which we spoke about, you know, the other time, seeking the Father to worship. The Father seeks them to worship him in spirit and in truth. Both are very, very important, spirit-to-spirit communication, and then let it be sincere, let it be in the truth of the word of God. He goes on to say, I know the Messiah is coming, who is called the Christ. He will tell us all things. So you see, it was not only the Jews, even the Samaritans, who the Jews didn't think were clean. Everybody was waiting for the Messiah. Even till now, many of them are waiting for the Messiah. And they believe that that Messiah is the one that will tell them all things. So the concept of the Messiah, the whole thing about the Messiah, they like, they welcome, they enjoy. But when the actual Messiah came, they missed out. Because they couldn't perceive beyond the physical. They couldn't, that spirit-to-spirit communication did not exist. And so, even though they had the Messiah right with them, they were not able to enjoy the benefits of it, and they missed that. That's why it says, came unto his own did not accept him. That's what the Bible says, his own, the very ones he made, he created, he formed. You know, they did not accept him. But Jesus said, I who speak to you, I am. That's the truth about that thing. If you look at that thing, that's placed very, very well, especially if you're in King James or New King James. I like them because there's something they show us there. There are some words and phrases they leave in italics. When they leave it in italics, they are trying to say either that word was not there, they added it to make it sensible, or they were not sure of the meaning of that particular word or phrase. So they will leave it in italics. I like that. A lot of these other translators, they will just go on and will not put this italics there. It's good to humble oneself. And so, I who speak to you, I am he. That he is in italics. In other words, either was not there. It was just added to make it sensible, or they were not sure what was there. But I believe that what I who speaks to you, I am. And one of those I am scriptures that Jesus will bring up, because he knew who he was. This was God. And so he was able to say, I am. There are about two or three places there in the Bible, just like God called himself, I am, because he is God. And at this point, the disciples came and they marveled that he talked with the woman, yet no one said, what do you see? Why are you talking with her? The woman then left her water pot, went away into the city, said unto the men, come, see a man who told me all things I ever did. Could this be the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came to him. In the meantime, the disciples urged him to eat, saying, Rabbi, eat. But he said to them, I have food to eat of which you do not know. Let's quickly talk about it again. The disciples came. They were surprised that he was talking with this Samaritan woman, because typically they look down upon these people. They wouldn't talk to them, just the way some ethnic groups or some races and things. Some of us have a way of looking down on them for whatever reason. Best of us, I believe that God created everybody, and we should have that understanding that God created everybody, and we don't need to look down upon anyone. But they never said anything. But the woman did something. Left her water pot. She had found something more important. She had found somebody that could possibly be the Messiah, could possibly be. So she ran into town and, you know, told people, come and see somebody that told me all that I ever did. Now listen to me, that kind of woman, typically the people were not going to listen to her, because they saw her as somebody maybe who was loose, or somebody who didn't have quite a good testimony among them. They didn't quite respect her like that. They were not going to listen to her. But the statement she made, this person told me all I ever did. In other words, what some of you are guessing, what is just speculation with some of you, what is just rumor with some of you, what you are not very sure of, somebody told me everything. Could this be the person we all are waiting for? And they followed the woman. You know, they went out of the city and came to him. That's what the Bible says. They followed the woman on account of that testimony. We are back to power evangelism again. Power evangelism. The moment this thing is there, it has an effect upon people, and they are able to draw more people onto Christ. And then he told the disciples, I have food to eat of which you do not know. His hunger, his tiredness, everything has disappeared, because he found an opportunity to win a soul because of the value of the human soul. Jesus was the one who said somewhere, he says, put the whole world on one part of the scale and put one soul on the other part of the scale. He says that one soul will weigh more than the whole world. That's what Jesus implied when he said that. But how can a man gain the whole world and lose his own soul? That's what he was saying. One of them, you know, certainly weighs more than the other, and is the soul, just one soul, weighing more than the whole world. That is God's own kind of mathematics. And Jesus had seen this, that this is a soul bigger than food, bigger than anything else, and he was gonna go for that. And by the grace of God, we will conclude this some other time, but I think it's a good place to round off for this morning, just to encourage us again to get to know this God, to serve him in spirit and in truth, or to walk with him, to worship him in spirit and in truth, to do power evangelism, and that to understand the value of a human soul. I pray this morning that God will help us to appreciate what I'm talking about this morning, that God will flood the eyes of our hearts with light, that we may appreciate what the value of the human soul by the grace of God. Have a good day and have a good work week. Bless you.